in 1999, we have built a rock solid organization that outperforms its peers, differentiates and innovates through digital. We have consistently delivered strong financial results and favorable returns to our shareholders. We have a differentiated corporate culture with 20,000 Mindtree minds around the world. A hostile takeover by Larsen & Toubro, unprecedented in our industry, could undo all the progress we have made and immensely set our organization back. We do not see any strategic advantage in this transaction and strongly believe that the transaction will be value destructive for all shareholders. Our collective success depends on building and nurturing relationships with our clients and partners. This unexplainable transaction will bring disruption to those relationships and impair Mindtree's ability to differentiate itself in the market and continue to deliver client value and great shareholder returns. As an organization, we remain 100% committed to our long-term vision of building an independent company. We believe that's in the best interest of our shareholders, Mindtree Minds, and our organization overall will continue to oppose this takeover attempt. In addition, there has been a large outpouring of sentiments from Mindtree Minds online at hashtag Mindtree Matters, expressing their strong desire to retain our culture and independence. We have seen the communication from L&T on their strategy for pursuing this transaction. Having carefully studied all the available information and documents, we have 5 questions for L&T. The first question: you have chosen to mount the first ever hostile takeover in the 50-year-old unblemished Indian IT industry. If you persist in what you are doing, you will forever be remembered for this. Is this how you want to set an example? Question number 2. You are a company with a turnover of 120,000 crores. You are 18 times the size of Mindtree. Why can't you build a great technology business with your resources and capability without disseminating another organization? Question number 3. Our customers choose us for our unique culture. They will stall all future business and even take their business elsewhere. In the process, you would have demolished shareholder value for both the companies. Is this the right thing to do? Question number 4, and a very important question. This is a people business. Mindtree Minds have signed up for a mission, not just a salary. Take their mission away and they will go. What will you be left with? And question number 5. If companies of great repute like L&T behave with extreme hostility to first generation entrepreneurs, what message are you giving to all startups in the country? Are we giving a message that honest, credible, high integrity entrepreneurs have to give up their company? And that is question number 5. So with that, I'd like to take or turn it over to you for your questions. Thank you.
Mukta from CNBC TV 18. Mukta from CNBC TV 18, sir, today the L&T management said that, you know, the Mindtree management had met them a few years ago, but that didn't fructify. L&T management said that the Mindtree management met them a few years ago, but that didn't fructify. So what was different then, and, you know, why is it hostile now? And secondly, what are the options for you once
you know, if mine, if L&T does get a controlling stake, will the management and the founders stay on or not?
See, I cannot answer question number two, but again, when L&T has made a public announcement that they pursued us, it was they who pursued us and it was we who rejected that option. So let's be very clear, our stand 4 years earlier and now has been the same. No, there will be various options, because at the end of the day, I think this is not a question of what needs to be done. Like we said, I think we have built a great company. Our customers love it for us. Our Mindtree Minds love the great work environment and what options they give. And to that extent, we'll pursue every option. Like we stated, we remain 100% committed to our long-term vision of building an independent company.
Not up to us to find an option, right? That shareholder chose to sell, and we have no problem if he sold it to anybody who did not have a strategic intent like L&T has. So at the end of the day, it is not my responsibility to find an option for a shareholder who wants to sell. So if it was anybody else who bought it, maybe it would have not led to this kind of a hostile reaction from us as well.
The question is, what options are there for us going?
The options in front of us right now is to make sure that our message gets heard, and we request all of you to carry our side of the story as much as, you know, the thing is, historically over the last few weeks for various reasons we had to stay silent, and now we want to take this opportunity to meet all of you, explain our point of view, so we want to reach out to the larger world, from a shareholder and an investor perspective to you, convince them on the logic that we have, and hopefully also then convince them not to support this acquisition that L&T would like to do of Mindtree.
Rostam, I have one question. This is not an overnight, you know, stake sale that has happened. This has been in the pipeline for 8-9 months. Why couldn't have the promoters devised a plan or taken the possibility of a hostile fit really seriously? And at any point in time, did you even think that this was a possibility, or you thought that the entire stake sale that Siddhartha would be doing would be amicable? And also, having spoken to so many other, you know, private equity players, what really went wrong, and why weren't you able to convince these PE players to be on your side or be able to negotiate this deal? Because, you know, all of us have been writing about Mindtree reaching out to private equity players, and suddenly we see L&T all of a sudden come and do this hostile takeover. This could have been averted, right?
It could have been averted under different circumstances, right? At the end of the day, like I said, it is a shareholder who wanted to sell, and if he chose to sell in whatever form or fashion,
but
timing, quantum.
The relationship that you have admittedly said that you had with Siddhartha has been so fine, and he's been a patient investor for 20 odd years. It is a little difficult to believe that you were not on talking terms at the end of this entire deal.
In the way it finally turned out, as of whatever yesterday evening when this announcement came, it was a surprise. Now, I'm not going to comment on how long we were in discussion, whether it was 8 months, 9 months, whether we spoke to A, whether we spoke to B, etc., because all that is water under the bridge. We were presented with a set of facts yesterday evening, and we are dealing with those facts as of now.
So you've said that customers and employees will, you know, leave if these this deal goes through. Is that something that gets communicated categorically to you?
Just watch hashtag Mindtree Matters on Twitter, right? So therefore you'll get a sense of all the outpouring of the reaction from clients.
Yeah, we'll probably take it.
Sir, the L&T
first lady and then of course Rahul.
I have two questions. You said that you are speaking here as Mindtree and not just as a promoter. Can I ask, are you also speaking on behalf of the entire board? Will the independent directors have to set up a committee to look into this deal?
Like Rosto said, the information has come to us last night. In fact, the mail was received this morning. So obviously the independent directors will set up a committee and evaluate it on merits. But what I'd like to state is our 52-week high was 1183. The deal has been done at 980. That itself reflects the value of the transaction.
And secondly, the independent directors' question would only be to whether to support the open offer or not, because as per law, they have to make a recommendation to shareholders whether to participate or not participate in the open offer. So the independent director's view will be restricted to that. KK, Subrato and I speak for all of Mindtree, for all the other constituencies that we represent. And that is not only shareholders and not just a share value question. It's a question like KK pointed out in terms of the culture, the people, the customers, the numerous social causes that we support, and all the global stakeholders that we stand for are the constituencies that we represent in today's communication.
See, I'd just like to share one thing. Partha, who's the chief operating officer, because we also have a year closing, and to that extent, we have ensured that there's not going to be a beat which we'll miss on our business. So Partha is right now in the US chasing business, so he's not here. Rahul, you had a question?
Yeah. So we've had Rahul for BT now. We've had the L&T chairman, Mr. Nayak, say that, L&T is a strategic company. If it would have been a key player, they would have been a lot more harsher than this. So how would you respond to that, sir? You mentioned about the fact that this is more hostile.
The manner
it was used is just a lot more harsher. I don't believe he said that.
He indicated that the thing would have panned out quite more differently.
It would have been more demanding, is what he said.
See, again, to classify a set of investors as being harsh and somebody else as being good, I think it's personal opinion of people.
Hostility is hostility.
Hostility is when you're very, after all, we had a great Me Too moment. This is a Me Too moment in the corporate world.
And hostility is not just in terms of the shareholding, the hostility is also because of the fact that this particular group has competing businesses with us. And to that extent, obviously, that's the reason for us not to be happy with this occasion. Secondly, there's a completely different corporate culture. Now, if it was a financial investor, they wouldn't do anything to tamper with the corporate culture because they would stay as shareholders and expect whatever returns, etc., etc. There would be, Mindtree would not become part of some group and have to abide by group policies and any of those kind of factors. So those are the reasons that why this particular investment, in our opinion, is a hostile investment.
Narendra from Press Club of India. I have a couple of questions. Mr. Siddharth, had pledged shares in June 2018. Has he made any disclosure about